I'm here with Rutger van Bergen today. Can you tell me the name of your company and where it's based?
Yeah, we are Catalaxy and we're based in Estonia.
Can you tell us a little bit more about the company's activities and what your interest is in being at the summit here today?
Our activities, we started 3 months ago in Estonia, and our activity is helping e-commerce platforms in Africa with a stablecoin and a smart contract platform in order to increase trust on their platform so they can increase their revenue in e-commerce, because trust is a big issue in Africa, especially in digital markets. So we're helping them with that. Yeah, and our interest here is, just meet as many people and tell our story and learn from other people what they're doing and see what comes out of it. So it's like looking for serendipity and exploiting it. So, yeah.
And having e-commerce activities in markets in Africa is quite a new approach. Can you tell us a little bit more about the challenges that you have faced so far?
Yeah, so we're working with a partner in Africa. So they're dealing with their own issues. What we're trying to do is help them dealing with their issues. So since we're licensed as a software company, we're providing them those services. So we have a low touch. We don't have to be physically based in Africa. We're providing the software. And so in that sense, we're avoiding some of the African problems of incorporation, of trying to do business over there. Might be later on that we need to go there, but at this time we want to test our system. So once we solve the technical hurdles, then later on we can think about actually being in Africa, but at this point this is not an issue. So,
And as a new startup firm, what are a couple of the challenges that you have faced when it comes to entering the market?
It's really difficult to explain to people what you're actually doing. So of course, this is a new technology, blockchain in general, and it's moving so incredibly quick. I think it's the quickest moving technology in human history. There's so much new ideas coming up. There's so much new technologies supporting those new concepts. Try to explain that to investors, let's say, like if you're trying to attract capital. Of course, like there's this bear market going on right now. It doesn't say, okay, the technology, I mean, it's going up in some sense right now, so, but it doesn't say that the technology is unpromising, but still some investors might look at that, or some people might look at that, so okay, this is not going in the right direction, but I think it's quite difficult right now to attract interest and explain what you're doing, because there's a lot of exotic stuff going on, so yeah.
And I imagine you're quite familiar with the regulatory framework for blockchain in Malta. Can you expand a little bit on that?
I don't know exactly the exact regulations that are put in place. I mean, it's very complex, but I think it's a good move for Malta to do this. I mean, it would be very nice if we can experiment. We should experiment with these new technologies. We don't know where it's going. We have some inkling where it's going, but we need spaces in which people can come that are creative, that are ambitious, that want to take a risk, and actually in local little regulatory sandboxes can figure out how the technology works. So actually can go to the customer and actually bring some real utility, right? It's not only crypto enthusiasts that can sustain this space, so we need to move there. And I'm not, so I hope that Malta can provide the regulatory framework for that. So I'm hopeful, so that's great.
That sounds really good. And last of all, what do you think of the summit so far? How did you enjoy your day yesterday?
Good people, interesting stories. I love the conferences. If I have time to go there, then I listen to those. Good energy. Keep it up. Yeah.
That sounds really good. Thank you for your time.
Thank you very much for your time.